All right, surprised or not over this announcement?
Not at all surprised. We've known that this was coming, and it was really just a matter of when.
Why are you not surprised? Because she lost the election last year, so change may have been inevitable. What do you think?
Well, more so because she lost two elections. So it was, I mean, it was time, and they were really close this last year, but, you know, they just didn't quite make it across the line. And you have to make some difficult decisions when that happens. And if you're the leader, well, you might be handing the reins over to someone else.
What does it mean for the Alberta NDP?
I think it's a good thing. It gives them an opportunity to, you know, really solidify their message going into the next election. Even though it's 3 years away, they have to decide who they are, and they have to decide who they want to be. This gives them that opportunity to, you know, start fresh or continue down the same road that they've been going.
I know that when Rachel Notley became premier, you know, we covered it extensively here at CTV, you know, there were those who said, look, that victory in 2015 was sort of a one-off, that it was a change election, that, you know, the NDP were not a natural fit to run Alberta. And certainly under Notley, we saw, you know, a different kind of NDP, you know, than we see in other provinces for sure, certainly more centrist than we see elsewhere, such as in British Columbia. Your read on how significant that was when Rachel Notley won that election for Alberta?
Oh, it was huge. I mean, it wasn't just that it was a change election where we finally, I mean, I was born after the PCs became government in the 70s. So I had never seen another government in this province. So it was, I mean, that was historic to begin with, but also it was the NDP. The NDP has never been government in Alberta. The most left of center that we've had was the Liberals. And, you know, it had been over 100 years since they were in power, I think 2019. So, like, we just, it was massive. And I have to say that in Alberta, everything is more conservative, even the NDP.
Yeah, well said. So how much as well of that victory do you think, and also, you know, the political clout that Rachel Notley had, continues to have, was about her personally, as opposed to, let's say, the Alberta NDP brand? Can you just kind of give us your read on that? Because, you know, to a certain extent, Rachel Notley was, you know, given a lot of respect by people, even if they didn't agree with her politics, Deirdre.
Absolutely. She's, you know, Grant Notley, her father, was the first NDP, I believe, the first NDP MLA elected in the province. And he held that in a rural riding in northern Alberta. He was very well respected. And I think that Rachel Notley was able to not only continue that, but she's very personable, and she is very pragmatic. And I mean, as long as they seem to stay out of the weeds of partisanship, you know, they seem to be very good, and Rachel Notley was great. However, Rachel Notley is still wearing the oil and gas downturn that started before she was elected, but she's wearing it.
It really is a two-horse race, provincially anyway, in politics, between the Conservatives and the NDP. Your thoughts on anyone who may take over as leader of the party, someone who can...
I'm sorry, I seem to have lost you.
Can you still hear me, Deirdre?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Yeah, I was just asking you about who you think might step up to the plate and say, hey, you know, I'd like to take over from Rachel Notley. Anybody who jumps out for you?
There's about three people so far that we are expecting to announce very shortly. That's Kathleen Ganley. She was former justice minister when the NDP was in government. She's the only Calgary NDP MLA right now that we're thinking of. We also have Racky Pancholi. She was just elected in 2019, so we haven't actually seen her in a government role. And then we have Sarah Hoffman, an Edmonton NDP MLA, who was our former health minister as well as the deputy premier. So we've got some strong candidates already looking at the leadership, and who knows who else might pop out.
What do you think we're going to hear from Notley when she speaks?
I hope that it is I hope that it's positive. I mean, she has a lot to be proud of. She took a party with three seats into government. She took the NDP into government for the very first time. I think they had, you know, they had a rough 4 years while they were in government, but I think they did really well. They were very pragmatic. They were actually not the spendthrifts that anyone should think they are. I think she's got a lot to be proud of, and I think she should be proud of the caucus that she has, and that she's going to essentially continue to lead, and who will continue to learn from her experience. So I hope that it's a positive thing for her. I do believe that she's been holding off on this moment for longer than she would like. So I think it'll be good for her. I think she's going to be able to relax and just represent the people of Edmonton Strathcona.
Deidre Mitchell-Maclean joining us. Good to see you as always. Appreciate you taking the time amid this breaking news.
Thank you very much, Todd.